Greetings. I'd like to introduce you to a new, unique, and highly innovative diatonic harmonica. It's called the MORBENDZ. It's the first full harmonica to be released in my new X-Reed partnership with Andre Coelho. So this is our business model. I'm the crazy inventor, making up weird stuff. Andre's the guy who's, keeping his eye on it, making sure that it works really well, and then assembling the harps into beautiful, playable instruments that that people are going to love. So what is this harp, the MORBENDZ? Well, the name says it all. A standard Richter harmonica has only got 8 bends. It's got 20 reeds, but only 8 of them will bend. You know, it's a little bit sad in a way. There's certain notes you can really get some great soul on, and you can get chromatic notes out of, but the rest of the notes are just, there's just no bending at all possible. It was that glaring, expressive limitation of the Richter harp that inspired me to design the MORBENDZ. And as its name implies, it just gives you more bends. Instead of 8 bends, as on the standard Richter harp, this one's got 14 bends. And the bends are all the missing notes that you can't normally do anything with. So this is in the key of C, and this is in the key of C. So here's your 8 draw in a normal harp. On this one, and here's your 9 draw on a normal harp. You can't do anything with it. This one here, and here's your 7 blow on a normal harp. Okay, and this one here, and 6 blow. And this one, 5 blow, this one, and another one that's, it's really important to be able to get is in the bottom octave, the 2 blow. On the MORBENDZ, that number 2 blow can be bent. Okay, so every single missing note on a Richter harp that you can't bend normally can be bent on the MORBENDZ. But in its default state, it just plays like a normal harp. Okay, so you can play exactly all the normal stuff you do on a normal harp, but it does have within it all those missing bends. So how am I getting those bends? Well, it's so simple. All I'm doing is pressing this button on the end. I call it the mouth slider, and it's something that I invented for my switch harp that I brought out many years ago. So it's a combination mouthpiece and slider in one unit. Very comfortable. And the nice thing is that your lips, because they're sort of flexible, you can just stay in the same place on the harp, press the button, just one push, and you get all those extra bends. That's 6 extra bends just with pressing a single button. It's like a soul button. Basically, you can just go to a place where there's normally not a bend as part of your normal licks and then press the button and you get the bend. So, like if I just did a little run up the middle octave. So I'm just going up to that 7 blow, pushing the button, and suddenly I can get some vibrato and soul on it. Or here's an example of a little kind of bluesy riff in the middle octave where I'm ending on the 6th blow. Normally you can't do anything with that 6th blow. Okay, now when I get to that 6th blow, I just press my soul button on the MORBENDZ and wow, you can get some, vibrato and bending on it. Okay, hear that? That's 6th blow and I'm putting vibrato on it. So even a trite little nursery rhyme like Mary Had a Little Lamb on a C harp. Okay, there's nothing you can do with those blow notes. On the MORBENDZ, you can play it that exact same way. But if you want to, you can put soul on those blow notes. Okay, so I'm just playing the same tune, but when I want to, I can really add, just press the button, leave my mouth in exactly the same place, press the button, and get soul on those notes that normally don't have it. So that's a really easy way to incorporate this soul button into your normal playing. Just play as normal, and then when you want some soul on a note that normally doesn't have it, press the button, and there it is. But if you want to go a bit further, you can actually leave the soul button pressed in, and then you get some really interesting stuff going on. For instance, take the top octave on a normal C harp, you know, like the special 20. Okay, that's, I can do that on my Morbenz without, with the button out. But now if I push the button in and start on hole number 7 and use exactly the same mouth movement and whatever, I've got a mirror image, well actually it's a reproduction of the top octave, but now it's in the middle octave. So just to illustrate this, I'll use another harp from the testing process. This is one that Andre's done a little bit of reed work on. Now, if I press the soul button in and just go to hole number 7, I'd get exactly the same pattern as my top octave normally is. So if you just go to the middle octave, flick a switch in your brain and think, right, I'm in the top octave, but your mouth is all doing it all stuff in the middle octave, you can do exactly the same riffs. So, okay, so basically, you've got a, you know, if you leave that button pressed in, you've got the top octave pattern in the middle octave, if you want to just leave it in. And here's another really cool application of the same concept. So here's an example of transferring a middle octave lick. Okay, that would be easy to play for anyone on a standard harp. Now, push the button on the Morbenz, start on hole number 8. Do exactly the same thing with my mouth and my bends, and I've got the same thing. That's magic. So this is some of the amazing potential of the Morbenz. It opens up areas of the Richter harp that normally I just don't have bending expression. Suddenly they do. And not only that, they're in your familiar breathing pattern from another area of the harp. So that middle octave stuff now transfers up to the top octave, and the top octave transfers to the middle octave. So how is this working? Because, you know, it's basically a standard harp, as you can hear. Then I press the button and I'm getting all these bends. So how's that happening? Well, it's actually a similar concept to my slip slider harp. I'm using the existing reeds and creating new reed pairings. And the slip slider does by moving the entire bottom reed plate from side to side in two directions. The Morbenz does it in a much more simple way by moving a front mouth slider just in one direction. And it gives you all those extra bends. The best way to explain this is by showing you with a diagram. Okay, I hope you now grasp the theory behind the harp. you don't actually have to know that to play it, because you can just think, well, I'll just play it like a normal harp, press the button, and I can bend the note that I normally can't. That's the basic concept behind it. That's all you really need to know. Well, after making this video, the next day I realized there's one really important aspect of the MORBENDZ that I'd forgotten to demonstrate, and it is this. You can play fully chromatically using bends alone on the MORBENDZ. So the new bends, the six new bends, allow you to get all those missing notes which on a normal harp you have to get with overblows. For instance, on a normal harp, to get the B flat, missing B flat on a C harp, you'd have to do an overblow. Now you can get it as a seven blow bend. Bend it up to the seven blow. The F sharp on a C harp, which is normally a five overblow, you can get that now as a bend down from the G on hole number six. So you just press the button and bend down, and you've got your F sharp. And same thing on your what would normally be a four overblow, the E flat on a C harp. You can now bend the E blow note in hole number five to get it. And the same thing happens with the overdraws. You just press the button in, and now you've got draw bends instead. So for instance, that C sharp note, which you'd normally get by an overdraw on hole number seven, you can now get it as a draw bend on hole number eight, which is the D note. It's exactly the same as you do down on hole number four. You can now get that by pressing the button in, going to hole eight, which is your D note, which normally can't be bent. Now you bend that down, and you've got the C sharp. And, you know, the same principle goes for hole number two, hole number 10. So between all these extra bends, you can get full chromatic scales on the MORBENDZ. So that sounds good in theory, but the cool thing is you can actually use them as part of nice new licks, which are really easy to play. I'll give you one little example. This is like a sort of a blues turnaround, which you can play in the middle octave. So I'll just play it for you first. Okay, so that is the kind of thing that would be really difficult to play using overblows. But with the MORBENDZ, you just press the button in and start doing some bends. In a future video, I'll demonstrate some licks and just show exactly what I'm doing with my with the sole button, where I'm pushing it in, and just break these things down much more slowly. But you can hear, hopefully, that the MORBENDZ give you some whole lot more very cool and easy to get expression just using blow and draw bends, and it also makes it fully chromatic as well. So this has been a fairly long video because I've had quite a lot of ground to cover. It's a very innovative harp that's never been released before. Trying to demonstrate all the stuff it does and also explain why it works and how it works. It's taken a bit of time. But anyway, we'll be releasing some shorter playing videos coming up. I play with a kind of a single note lip piercing style, but Andre is a real expert with kind of a more tongue blocking chordal blues style. So he'll do a video in Richter tuning with the tongue blocking style to show you how that sounds on the MORBENDZ. A great American player that many of you will know of, a really nice guy as well, Todd Parrott, is really interested in kind of innovative diatonic harmonicas. And over the years I've sent him samples of some of my slip sliders, but I also sent him a version of the MORBENDZ, and he loves it. And he made a fantastic recording on this early prototype of the MORBENDZ. So that's the music you're hearing in the background. It's a fabulous track played by the wonderful Todd Parrott on the MORBENDZ. So thanks to Todd for that. It's only in a limited edition to start with, just to test the market, see what the interest is. And the first version is all in Richter and related tuning. So you could have Richter, you could have country, you could have melody maker, you could have natural minor, anything that's kind of related to Richter, and it's got the reverse breathing pattern in the top end. In the future, we're going to release a version which applies more to regular breath tunings like power bender, power draw, wild tuning. So that's coming up in the future. If you want to know more about the MORBENDZ and, you know, possibly even interested in ordering one, all the info and the link to the ordering page is in the description below the video. Okay, thanks for watching. Bye for now.